Fuck! So I did a mistake. I just played the rest of the turn, turn 18. Thought I was recording. Clicked on F9. And this symbol here reacted. Thought it was recording, but then I realized it was green. And it needs to be red for it to be recording. So I didn't record. So what I did was I clicked on some two settlements and started recruiting some units, and then I spoke. So I looked at the video, and my voice is recorded. It sounded just fine. The music is fine. The quality of the video is great, or awesome. It has the same quality as when I play. It's very good quality, but there is some shaking. For example, when I play a battle in this game, I have no lag, no stuttering, it doesn't shake, so it's seamless, it's very good. And when I record with the Shadowplay recorder in the past, I had the same experience when I watched the video as I had when I played it. But with the CD recorder that I'm using now, because the other one do not work anymore, Bandicam doesn't work either in this game, because I have updated drivers, but I use the CD recorder. So the music, the voice, and the video quality is awesome. But when I watched the battle, so the size of the video is so huge, and I believe it affects the playback of the video when I watch it. So it's like the battle has slight shaking that I didn't experience when I actually played the battle. But I don't think it's comparable to lag, and not stuttering either. But it has something that causes it to feel less seamless than when I actually played it. So it could be that the game quality and the video quality of the game being recorded in battle, that it's very demanding on the tool or something. With the Shadowplay recorder, you use the NVIDIA graphics card to record the built-in features. It doesn't lag at all, but with CD recorder, it's a separate tool like Bandicam or Fraps, and I believe it causes slight slowing of the battles, making it feel like it shakes a little bit. But I still thought it was fine to watch. I will upload the videos. Might either cut them into different parts, or I will upload one big video or two big videos, but we'll have to process them in Bandicam to see what happens with the video after I have done that, if the music or voice will be delayed compared to the scene, like they play the scene first and then the voice, or similar. That happens with AVI files when I used Bandicam in the past. So I'm using a BMV file format now, might be better. It was better in the past to use BMV file formats. Rate increase, Yaster link increase feels unappreciated. He's probably in one of the settlements. We have new units. Structure complete, edit near the turn report. So we'll attack this time this area, but we'll move stuff first and do recruitment. We'll go for the bandits, Goblin infantry, Goblin brassiers. Yeah, so 9161 7111. Yeah, I think these guys are better than the brassiers. Goblin infantry, maybe not. Let me check again. 486, yeah, they are better, more costly. In the capital, we can go for some elite stuff. Okay. Might have missed some settlements. Okay. Can't do anything there. Use Traveler's Lodge, to get spies and assassins. Should have built one of those already. Maybe it's not finished yet. Check. Diplomats and merchants. No, we haven't built one here. We're still constructing it, okay. So yeah, I had built two structures and decided to not attack because we wanted to wait one more turn to weaken them a little bit more. Here I have a Gurubashi diplomat. Might be kept, or the Farraki one will be kept, we'll see.
Orders? What do you need?
Right. A huge army now in the capital. The general outside. So, do we have any bad troops here? No, most of them are really good quality too. If we want to protect in case it's an alarm, we'll send something. We have a general outside. We can hire some mercenaries for that army. Build up this force next. We'll move him whenever he has a full force. Right. So these troops can start attacking. We don't want gunners.
Say the word.
Let's see. We'll move out the infantry.
Orders. Say the word.
Happen.
What do you need?
The troops. Okay, that's the infantry. Gurubashi area. General Sunseal, the outcast. The disciples of Hakar, bodyguard. We have the Gurubashi tribal warriors. Troll spears.
Orders.
That is infantry unit will be sent.
Say the word.
Okay. Cannons could lay siege to the bombards. I usually say cannons.
What do you need?
Old habit. Infantry, they are too far away to reach the army. Reach that army then. Alright.
Orders? Yes, my lord.
Say
the word.
Orders.
Yes, my liege. Orders.
AI can usually use archers. We saw in the last battle that they did use them in melee, so not always, but they are more likely to use archers correctly compared to, for example, mages or especially gunners. Okay.
Say the word.
Recover too, if they're attacked. Oh fuck, I moved wrongly. A rebel area here. Minor faction, Mott and Billy. Ogres. Mosh Og Ogre Mound, and we have a Stormwind Merchant. All Wardens. Gnolls. They are really bad but numerous, and then we have the Ogre Bone Crushers, Magi actually, Warriors, the General Kolach, the Ogres, Ogre Warriors. ogres, what god. So the ogres, all the three ogre units here. The ogre bone crushers, the ogre magi, and the ogre warriors, they are units of the Dark Horde. Regular units of the Dark Horde. The Gnolls and the Gnoll Wardens, they used to be the militia of the Dark Iron Wars in the past, but they changed to faction rebel units. Now they are mercenaries for the, I believe, the Dwarves, but especially the Dark Iron Wars, as they are available in the Dark Iron Lands and some in Kalimdor and such. But yeah, they are rebel units or Dark Iron mercenaries. But because the Dark Irons and the Kasmodan Dwarves share religion, they also share mercenaries. So yeah, they are mercenaries now. But we had the Dark Iron militia in the past. Okay, we'll move these guys back. Similar battle to the other troll towns we've taken, but it's held by a real faction garrison now, meaning that they will all be blue trolls, will all be Gurubashi jungle trolls, no Amani trolls. Alright, and we can attack actually. Gaggets and a goblin area. We have Warlord Sol, leader of the Farraki or the air. He's the air. Captain Jindo and the Sola General. So they sent reinforcements here, good. I wanted more of a challenge, it's more fun with more armies. Fight the battle on the battle map. Army strength ratio 3-2 in our favor. Time to take gadgets and we've had a computer on for a very long time. I will try again. Okay. Still going. Let's start up the game. Okay. Hope it won't crash again. If it does, it's gadgets and it is causing the crash. We'll see. That will suck. Then we'll try to fight the battle outside of the settlement instead. So we want to fight the epic battle between the Trade Coalition Goblins and the Farraki Death Trolls there. Goblins and their human troll and ogre had allies. Be a pretty cool battle. Takes a while to start. This computer is really slow nowadays. It's become really slow the last year or so. The last 2 years. At least the last year. Probably need to leave it in the store and have it cleaned for all the dust and shit. But I don't know if that would fix it. Used to be way faster in the past, that's for sure. always takes forever to start up a mod like this. Sound. We'll have to double check the sound when we're in the game. In the actual campaign map. Right, we're back in the game. The map. This could be 66. And music. Could have higher music probably. Maybe 16. Okay, so if it crashes again now, then we know that something is wrong with gadgets and or one of the generals or such here. I think it would be gadgets and I don't see why the generals would crash. No, it worked, so I had had a game on the map for like 8 hours or so while I were sleeping. So when you leave the game on for a long time, then it can crash randomly, like it did. It happens in battles, and it happens on the map in many modes. So that's why it's a bad idea to leave it on for a long time if you want to continue. Better to exit and start it up again. I didn't plan to go to sleep, I just became very tired when I left the game. I played for 5 hours and been awake, I believe, an entire day, most of the day and the evening, and then most of the night. Yeah. Okay, because I played during the night, from the evening and during the night. Okay, let's start deployment. We use the camhack mod. We can zoom in. Here we have some elite units. We have the Goblin rockets. They are sappers throwing dynamites, the enemies, well, riding rockets, they work exactly like the bat riders of the trolls. The difference that they throw dynamites and the trolls throw some kind of bomb. They are similar, but the difference is also that the rockets are way, way faster than the trolls. When you use these units and the Wyvern riders or the Hippogriff riders of the Night Elves, Wyvern riders are unique to the Horde, I believe. When you use these units, they are ranged cavalry like horse archers, flying ranged cavalry. You need to, one, use loose formation to help in preventing them from being hit by other missiles. From enemy missiles, but also you need to use the circle and shoot. It will allow the unit to fly around in a circle and fire at the enemy, and then when the enemy gets closer, they will fly away all the time, which is very good for these guys, as they are really fast. No other unit can hunt them down, but if you don't use it, they will just fly up to the enemy and fight in melee after a while and be killed off. They are not good in melee. So if you don't want them to die unnecessarily in melee, you need to have circle and shoot on. Also, I believe that even with circle and shoot, they are not very good, simply because they do not have unlimited dynamites. I think it would have made sense to use those backpacks of the goblin sappers. It would have looked better when I think about it. I don't know why these guys do not use the backpacks. I mean, where are they getting their dynamites from? Anyway, unless there are dynamites here somewhere that they can pick it out or something. But anyway, they don't have a lot of ammunition. So they are only good as long as you have ammunition, then you should retreat the unit. You have limited ammunition. You went for realism when it came to ammunition and such. Okay, we don't want the mages to be the crew. The necrolites. These guys have horde skins. They will be changed to have the dark horde skins, I believe. Horde skins might fit the goblins, but they don't fit the dark horde where they are a regular unit there. I mean, they have skins for the legion, for the dark horde, and for the horde, but since I made it a mercenary, that you can only use one skin, unless I give a try to every single faction in the game, like I did with the elven rangers, to allow them to have different skins for different factions, like for example the many of the alliance nations have the white skin with pink hair. Lordran has the blue one. The High Elves have the blue one. The Blood Elves have the red one. The Dark Irons have the red one. And such. The Undead have the Undead skin. If we had not given that try to every single faction, they would have shared one skin, and that wouldn't have fit certain factions. Here, the green ones kind of fit the goblins and the horde. They don't fit the dark horde. But they are criminals, maybe that's why I went with this. Thought they fit better with the goblins and the horde, and even if they are in the dark horde, they are outlawed in the horde, so that's why the dark horde may accept them. So maybe I picked the green skin because it fit with the horde and the goblins, and made sense that the dark horde would still accept them in their ranks. They are outlawed from the horde. They're only mercenaries there. We have these guys, we saw them in another battle. Ranged cavalry. Don't need them right now. We have only ranged units. Let's group the same units, the pirate musketeers. We one group. Then we have the highwaymen and the Trolls, they could be one group. Move them closer. And then we have... these guys could also be a part of the pirate group. It could be two lines, we have too many. Bikes over there. Cavalry on the other side. General's bodyguard could be over here. We don't want to waste our best range unit, the artificers. They can be stationed here. There. I've had another one of these. Let's group them again. Two rows. We don't have any infantry. We will not send in these guys then. We don't need to use them unnecessarily. We will use the bodyguard and the ram. They will have to handle the gatehouse. And as for our other armies, we had bombards here. They will be ordered to attack immediately as soon as the battle starts. The reason I don't want them in one of the armies is because then the army will not use the rams and they will instead spend all the ammunition first, which takes forever. So we have this army, they have the shredders, entire unit of shredders. Death Stealers, Goblin Infantry, especially I like the ones with helmets, they look cool. Alright, and Skeleton, Orc Skeletons actually, handing one of the rams, Bandits, handing the other one. The bandits look cool too, like militia, but different with better stats. We have the captain here. So this tail gunner is the captain. He's bodyguard of Tinkers. Best unit in their armor ranks, that's the best one. The bandits. Goblin army is much more fun now when it's not just goblins. This is also how it was intended to be. The old release, they still had the ogres, the trolls, and the pirates, and the bandits, and such, but they were only available in certain areas on the map, so you hardly ever got to use them. Because you started in goblin areas, and then you needed to go to human areas to get the bandits, you needed to go to troll areas to get the trolls, and you needed to go to ogre areas to get the ogres, so they were rare. Now you get everything from all the locations, which is better. They are regular troops instead of regional troops or area of recruitment troops. They have some pirate musketeers. And the highwaymen really need this. Minor factions. Now they are a proper unit of the goblins. They fit. They are criminals too, like the bandits. They were mercenaries in the past and rebel units. Now they are mercenaries, but they are also regular troops of the goblins. The goblins are not just goblins. They are majority goblins and led by goblins. Okay, we will see. That was their main army. And they have another army over here. A lot of rebels. Their worst infantry unit. Their numbers. No strength, no quality. Heavy infantry. Reseers, they are pretty good. Shock infantry. A lot of rabble. Cannon fodder essentially of the goblins. here to take the hit while the gunners empty their guns. Then we have the undead raised by the necrolite mercenaries. We have a few of them. 172. And more here. 125. Some orc skeletons. It's the bodyguard of the captain. The gunner captain. Orc skeletons are a bit better than the human skeletons, but they are still bad quality. They are still just cannon fodder. The benefit of using skeleton cannon fodder is that they never break. They have unlimited morale. These armies still have a lot of skeletons. Okay, start the battle. We don't need ram here actually. Okay, then, and I don't want to use the bombards, as they might kill our troops, to be honest. Maybe, I don't know. Let's attack this army first, the allied army, with the skeletons and mercenaries and rabble. We'll waste it first, the worst army. We don't want the bombards to fire, as they might kill our troops instead of the enemy. We want them to waste the rabble and skeletons. Mercenary troops. Even though the rabble is a regular troop with the goblins too, but it's literally the worst one in the roster. So this battle had some stuttering. That can happen randomly. Usually when armies enter battles. I don't know why we have it here. Could be the light weather. Had that before. When the weather is clear, that it has had more stuttering than when it hasn't been as clear. These guys moving too. No. Oh, and we will allow these guys to attack as well. And these guys, I forgot that the enemy had armies outside. They had a lot of armies outside. Hampshire archers. Forgot about these guys, axe throwers. Their armies are similar to the smaller trolls, the Mani and the Gurubashi. With the yellow skin, but these guys are not really skins, they are actually unique models. They must have some details that are different, because they have unique entries, but they are essentially the same in type of troll. So you have like axe throwers, spearmen, warriors, etc. But with the difference that... they have unique entries, so I don't believe they are just reskins. I could be wrong. Might be some modal differences there between the Farraki and the Gurubashi. Different armor, maybe. Slightly different armors and helmets. But the Amani smaller trolls are just the same as the Gurubashi ones, with different skins. They went for the bombers. They'll be steamrolled. Kill the crews. Okay. We have ogres here joining the fight. They have the warriors, Sanctuary warriors, Farraki, Sanctuary axe throwers. I totally forgot that they had armies outside of the settlement. So we are surprised. Kill the numerical advantage. They also have these scorpions. They would crash without the M2DV UP tool. They are elephants, giants, using an animation from Heroes of War, but a model from World of Warcraft and Vale, rigged by Seriidan. There is a scorpion, a giant scorpion in Heroes 2, that is an elephant, using the same animation, with a different model. Oh, here are the Sanctuary Zealots and Elite units. The Farraki Trolls. Two-handed Axeman unit. And the Farraki Champions Bodyguard. Their Bodyguard. Two-handed Elite unit. Heavy infantry unit. They start to get better infantry. Skeletons do have, but they are actually light infantry. The scorpions are heavy cavalry actually, they are really good. With fewer numbers, but they are really, really powerful. They probably win that fight against the skeletons. Map. They are killing our combat crews. They were too few. We are sending old skeletons there. Bandits. Game can obviously be played strategically when you move around troops, etc. I used to play like that in the past, but nowadays I just like watching the old guys fight whenever I can. I enjoy the spectacle while trying out the game and seeing how it works and such, and enjoying the epicness of battles. I like enjoying battles without having to move them around and such. I like also sometimes to play it strategically and move troops around. This faction also has the enchanted Tiki warriors. They fight to the death because they are enchanted. They are elite. We are firing at them. Bikes. Can also easily outrun any normal cavalry of the game, being the second fastest unit in the game. The pirate musketeers, they are actually quite decent in melee with their sabers. Yeah, this unit looks pretty cool. The majority of the factions are using Warcraft 3 edited World of Warcraft models. So like World of Warcraft classic models, the oldest version of World of Warcraft edited for Warcraft 3 mods, and then rigged for Warcraft of the War for Medieval 2. So you got the models from Warcraft 3 modding sites, and then rigged them for Medieval 2. But there are also some fan-made models, like the many of the humans are fan-made. And we have Warcraft 3 models, like some of the undead and some of the orcs are Warcraft 3. Then we have fan-made models, made by others for Warcraft 3 mods, like the Dryad. and the Huntress is the Night Elves. These trolls are tall. They're bigger than the full skeletons. Oh, here's other units. Sanctuary Blood Drinkers. They used to be berserkers in some of the older releases. They are no longer berserkers because they didn't like them. Didn't like the berserker animation. It looked bad. They are still less powerful, essentially. It's not with that animation. They have the same stats otherwise. Slaughtering the skeleton. They are destroying the skeleton. The settlement is a Warhammer village originally from Warhammer Beginning to End Times. Added as the Horde village, shared with the Goblins and the Dark Horde. The Dark Horde has a custom black skin that we made. But the Horde and Goblins are using the same look as the Warhammer Orcs. Killed a lot of their scorpions already. Good. There's quite a few orc skeletons here. One thing that might change is the number of mercenaries, and I will speak to Seriidan what he thinks, if he thinks we should keep all the mercenaries as they are now, or if he thinks we should change anything. The numbers might change, because I based the numbers on how many cities a faction had. For example, if you had 7 trade coalition cities, we would have 7 units available, one from each city. If the number of settlements have been reduced, like for the goblins here, then it makes sense to reduce the mercenaries too. Probably. Right. I killed 73% and lost 29%. They are losing because they lack the numbers to win. I think we will avoid killing off their leaders and avoid attacking their capitals until we have taken rebel areas outside first. We'll go for rebels first. It's more fun that way. I never was a fan of killing leaders to kill factions. I don't like regicide. In Root of War, the regicide method doesn't work. You can take someone's capitals, they are still not destroyed. As long as they have a general left. They are destroyed when they lose their last leader, a general. But in this game, if you kill their leaders, they will destroy the faction. So you'll have to avoid that and take in the areas. If you take all the areas and they still have a leader left, they will also lose. building in Hyrule, that isn't the case. You can take all the areas and they still won't lose as long as they have a guy left. Right. Good that we took Gadgets and another goblin area. The next goal is to take rebel areas and then take Mudsprocket, another goblin area. We need to connect this area with Mudsprocket. That's the next goal. After that, connect that area to Ratchet. Probably. We'll avoid Venture Bay in Northrend. We'll also avoid probably the other area. The one next to the Night Elves, it's too far away. Have a look. The Goblin area. Even though I might try to take that one, but it's too far away. We also need to kill off the Farraki Trolls and the Gurubashi Trolls according to the victory conditions, so we'll do that. We are playing the short campaign, I believe, so we don't need to kill off Ankirai. Might still do it for fun, but we don't know if I will finish all of this that I just mentioned. But this is a playtest campaign. The map will be updated, I believe, tomorrow. Seriidan sent me a bunch of pictures showing his work on the Frozen Throne campaign. So he's still working on the Frozen Throne campaign, changing faction ownership of settlements and the colors of banners and map colors and moving things around, changing things. So he is working on the Frozen Throne campaign right now. But as he said, he was gonna start a job, working at a job on Monday. He'll probably have to finish the maps before that. We'll see. We'll see about the Giants too, if he will do anything. Or if he will have to use the old M23 UP tool. Person as well. Yeah, the goblins look really good. I don't really think the rebels look good, they look bad. But the goblin infantry looks really good. The rebels still look way better than the old goblin unit we had in the first release or so, which was based on Warcraft 3. At least this one is a well, Warcraft goblin, I believe. Just doesn't look too good. Looks a bit weird. Like it stretches and stuff. But it's still better than the old one. The arm stretches. The heavy one looks really odd. Lost a lot at 5% and we've lost 87% killed 87% of the enemy. We are winning. We didn't have the numbers to win. Not even with the reinforcements. At least the trolls put up a fight, unlike the rebels. The rebels were just a piece of cake with the help of mercenaries. Maybe without the mercenaries there would have been a challenge, but not with mercenaries. Helmet. Real. He's not worthless like the other unit. Followed Sul the Scared. The Scarred has been killed. One danger is the Tauren of the Horde, they are really overpowered in both of the Resolve and in Melee. They are really dangerous. They're better than Ogres too. They're like a stronger Ogre. Better than the human, the Shredders, the Goblins. Here 96% lost 39% of all our troops. I planned to use up the shitty troops first before sending in anything else, but sadly they had the troops outside that interfered. We had to use all the troops. Many of the bad troops survived. It's fine, this is far from the last battle. I disabled the battle voices of vanilla units, or units that didn't have custom sound. So if they do not have custom sound, they have no sound at all. Which I think is good. Harul had no sound for their units. I believe in 4.7 they added sound, like noises and such for different units, for all the units probably, but in all their versions they didn't have noises neither, and they never had voices. They would like to have voices for the undead, the horde, and the Naga. I believe we are using Karakas now for the Naga. He controlled both the Naga and the Blood Elves in Warcraft 2 control. But yeah, he would like to add voices for Lady Vash and Illidan for the Naga. And that Troll is a narrator for the Horde. And all the Troll sound, Horde sounds for Peons and such. And undead, of course, we have Death Knight Artis as the narrator. And undead units, we could have the undead over 3 at their voice lines. You'll see, there was another guy, Tucket, that did the humans and the night elves and the high elves, shattered the blood elves and the dwarves. So I tried adding voices for the humans in the past and I failed, but he fixed one thing. The game, so that the game could regenerate in sound. And after that, I believe I could probably add voices. I will need to read up a bit again, such. So yeah, more voices would be nice for the undead, the horde, and the Naga. As for others, I don't believe they will get it. So we would probably share the horde voices with the trolls, and the undead with the Reichel and the Forsaken, and the probably Asyl Neru could try the undead too, and Akirai could try the undead. But Legion, I think, could get their own if there are unique demon voice lines. Otherwise they try the undead. Everyone, 100% killed. We lost 40% of our troops. Alright, massacre. Our armies killed almost 1,000. Some of them, they killed 491 with Warlord Soul Disgust, the Scared. I don't know if it's Scared or Scarred. Probably Scarred. The Scared. You're afraid, so. But yeah, I don't know. Maybe you say it scared anyway. I'm not sure. I'm a Swedish guy, so I'm not 100% certain how to pronounce that. Okay, Gad gets 617 after the Dark Portal. Some night elves in the background. One of the Night Elven buildings. Probably Ashen Vale or something. could be wrong. Resistance is futile. Cat gets sand. Okay. This is an infantry army.
Say the word.
Send in. Send out these
the
guys.
Word.
They are marked.
Yes, my lead. Orders? Yes, my lead.
Oh,
what do you need?
Cavalry unit there.
Yes, my lead.
Okay.
What do you need?
Send out the necrolites. Makes sense, they are in the same armor as the skeletons. Over here and take an ogre mound. The ogres are quite powerful. They could also take a shimmering place here and go to the goblin area here and take it. I think we'll do that. Over here is the capital of the Farraki faction. We want to move it there. Oh, we had infantry here. Move them out.
Say the word.
The range units
here.
See infantry. Move over there.
Say the word.
We don't need the bombards in the same army. Training grounds, construct that. Think we can move the general over there. Hide some mercenaries. Rebel and bombards.
What do you need?
Hydromancer, Troll Ghast, the priest. I believe the Hydromancer was unique Farraki unit, so this one will probably be kept for the Farraki, the priest. Or replace the skin for the Gurubashi, it will make a new one for the Gurubashi. Keep this for the Farraki. Done, let's end the turn. They're attacking. It's reinforcement and entire army. Reinforce them. Captain Bakari. 2,887 trolls. Then we have Sansil the outcast inside the settlement. So the allied army. Huge army. Including troll axe throwers, can penetrate armor, so armor only counts for half its value. Gurubashi headhunters, same with them. Effective against armor. We have the troll warriors here. Medium infantry. Gurubashi primitives, unique unit, but it's a basic militia unit. Gurubashi blood slayers, an elite infantry unit. Serpentine guards, one of their best elite units. Jaguar warriors, inspired by the Aztecs too. The entire faction is inspired by the Aztecs, but this unit in particular. An elite unit. Shanta Tiki warriors, elite. Mounted troll spears, they have mounted spearman unit. They're troll archers. Mounted troll warriors. Mounted warriors, mounted spearmen. Troll raptor archers, but with the Farraki card, we'll need to replace that card. But yeah, it's mounted archers. And the horse archer unit, but with raptors as the mount and trolls as the riders. Okay, Gurubashi fanatics, elite infantry unit. We have entire army. But could have used some reinforcements. Could treat. Retreated with all of them. End of turn report. Construction report. Treatment report. Order clad King of Lordaeron against the Mani troll tribe. Goblin diplomat is being moved. Okay. Moving troops.
Say the word.
Sending reinforcements. Back a bit. So we'll have to stand our ground there if we're attacked.
Yes, my liege.
That on unit two. Let's check the settlements. Bim. Let's go for the vendors, the walls. Tenere, close trigger co. Alright, troops. Cavalry, Goblin infantry. Lost Trigger Co has better agents. They have agents. The reason it chose the female is because I wanted the female to be the assassin, but it's not the female in the game, it's the male. Also because this is the unit card for the assassin, so it was the card that was available. So we'll go for spy. Lost Trigger Co. Goblin infantry in Aberras. Goblin rabble in Booty Bay. And that's it. Can't do anything more there. Fleet could probably move here. Everything flat is at hand now. So let's see, Ravagers, Bodguard, Sun Cry, Rebels here. So let's see, Reavers, so let's see, Crawlers, so let's see, Drones, so let's see, Swarmers, and Slimes. Take that next. Wait one turn. Build, construct the rams. So town is better than a village. Then we can recruit troops. Mats property over here is over here. It's a goblin area, so we want it. All right. So yeah. Adjust the microphone. Let's end the turn. Your battery trolls might attack again, we'll see. They didn't. They're a bit too strong. Speakable treachery, Chris Ivan also. We lost the diplomat. Fuck. I turned into a troll. Troops. We lost the diplomat. Trolls hunted us here. Right. Could send. Army this turn. Also fight this battle most likely. So what we need to do first, we need to move out any ranged units. Right. We need to move out infantry from this army. Treat the troops first. So we have an entire infantry force there. Okay, match the unit.
Yes, my liege.
Cavalry. Right, and yeah, we will attack here first. So before we do that, we'll do the construction stuff. Start here. Right, dirt roads first. Vendor stalls and abras. See, leather tenier, booty bay. Let's see, undermine, go for siege. Can we do bombards? We don't need that. Martian swarf, we'll go for it. Okay. Troops and gadgets and use some infantry, we'll go for bandits. Abras, we could go for an assassin. Boot Bay. Go for some cavalry. And pay a troll ambushers. Let's hold bandits. Capital of Undermine. Go for Goblin rockets. No, we have no money. Okay, let's go for the Goblin bodyguard, Death Stealers, and Bandit Raiders. Bandit Raiders here too. Lost Rigger Co. Go for an assassin. Didn't I pick an assassin somewhere else? I did. Abras, we don't need that. Okay. We'll go for troops here. Highwaymen. Alright, done. So the Horde maybe is here. They're not an ally. Goblins are independent here. Don't need to attack, we are not at war. They are neutral. Let them attack. Okay, we'll attack this area now. Deployment. Hammock mode, mod this on. See the general, Tinker General. We don't need to use this. Could still use it with bodyguard. We don't need it on this settlement, it's another one of these village settlements. It's a town but using a village. It's the same as in the other battle. It's bad gadgets. Allied army. So this smaller force, very depleted, the Goblin infantry unit 1, should have disbanded it. Captain with the Oak Skeletons there, 151 probably for the unit, and we have the cavalry. 69 bandit raiders.
Cut your heart out.
The other side, the bombers. And then we have the large force here of infantry. Okay. Seen them before. Let's see here. Smaller force. Can attack immediately. And this army could also attack immediately. We don't need to use the bombards. Might hit our own troops. I wasted hero ability there. Doesn't matter. Bombards. Don't care about them. These are the smaller troops. They sent in the cavalry, of course. Selected swarmers. They are well for Warcraft classic models, the Ankarai units, but the animations for the swarmers are from Harut 4. the numbers. And in all the releases of Harut War, the Ankarai faction, but this is Rebels using Ankarai units, but in all the releases, I believe that the Ankarai units, they were easy to spam. They had very fast recruitment, they still have that, but now the new map is preventing them from expanding as fast. Here are the slimes. We are marking our unit for the Ankarai faction. Against rebels will usually not be much of a challenge. We've already killed 67% and lost 9%, we'll easily win. If the rebels have an entire army, or if they are obvious in dragonflight, then they might be a challenge. Sandalari have an entire army, I believe. Their general died. Modern orcs and more modern humans. skeletons. I was updating the humans in May. You have another beta with all map where I have changed the footmen and knights and captains and generals of the Terramorph faction and had a bunch of models made that I didn't implement yet. For Terramorph had also replaced the footmen of the Stormguard faction, I believe, maybe even the knights. Lost 11%. Modding site and use them, and we did it in 2018 and 2017, so before World of Warcraft Classic had been released. Back then World of Warcraft used modern HD models, and the classic models have been left for the past. Then a few years later World of Warcraft Classic released using the old models again. Okay, clear victory. Have it. We'll build the training grounds first, so we can get troops. Trade increase. We goblins. Goblin. Coalition. Okay. And I'm on my routes.
Orders.
Area 2. Okay, quite the area now. 8 regions. Alright. Move immediately towards Mad's Procket. Leave one unit here. Okay, we'll move the rest. There's a goblin area here that we want. We have Rebel Tauren here. Grim Totem Tauren, they're really dangerous. Might also get mercenaries in these areas, we'll see. I believe we get bandits here for sure. Human bands. Alright, we need to fight the other battle. Have new troops coming. 8. We need at least 4. We could fight this battle. Turns will take one turn until they reach Abras. We can only reach that army in 2 turns. Right, we could end the turn and hope they won't attack. We'll do that. Stormwind moved the merchant. They didn't. Have another general. Treatment report. New troops. Alright. Our troops. Where can they go? Units. Put them in. These two. The general. Have no money. Otherwise we would have been able to hire a troll unit. Vendors also need that. That's an air we needed. Dwarf, maybe training grounds, we certainly need that. Okay, let's skip that for now. We can hire the trolls. No, 900. Expands, yes, to increase mercenary captain. Alright. And we will fight this battle now. We'll first do the recruitment and movements on the other side. Goblin regions. We have already recruited mercenaries in these parts. We have a goblin army there. We'll have to take out. Okay. Recruitment. Go for the dirt roads and go to bay. We have no more money. It's time to fight this battle. We have the upper hand. I'm strange reach 7-5 in our favor. Let's say the game first. Let's fight the battle on the battle map. Lord. deployment, activate the hammock mod. For the army, all the infantry should be one group. And the light cavalry. AI control. And archers. They lose formation, fire my own. One group. All smiths and mages could be lose formation. Bombard could be lose formation and flaming ammo on. Fired wheel on as well. The border guard could be behind the rest of the army. Some of the troops are few. Two tinkers, that's worthless. 6 goblin rabble, worthless. 126 bandits, we have a full unit of bandits. 150, no, we're not full, but the bandits are okay. Goblin braziers, 158, that's okay. 35 ogres, okay. 32 cavalry, that's weak, but still better than none. 7 skeletons, pretty worthless. 14 orc skeletons, pretty worthless. We had mostly spent infantry. We had a lot of missile units too. 6 trolls, they should have been disbanded. We will disband more troops later. Let's move them in there. And these guys. And a mage. Here is the enemy army. So we have the Jäger warriors. Haven't seen them before in this campaign. Look really cool. Elite infantry unit. 79 warriors. 79 guards maybe. Check. Okay. Troll warriors. Bloodslayers. They used to be berserkers. They are no longer berserkers, but they are still as good in their stats. Used to not have the berserker animation because it looked bad. But these guys, they are also elite. The Gurubashi fanatics. Our allies far away. Axe throwers. Headhunters, troll archers, a unique militia unit, the Gurubashi. We have some cavalry too. Here's their captain, Bloodslayer captain. They have the mounted troll spearmen, some blue raptors. All the trolls have similar. Mounted cavalry, that unit. Here are the other cavalry, should be over here. Mounted warriors, all the trolls are mounted warriors too. Or similar. Maybe missed one. There are the troll archers over here. They are dangerous, stay here. Mounted archers. You can also see that the raptors are different, like strings. Different colors on the backs if they are ranged. They are blue and like brown. And the infantry, the mounted infantry. Actually, the warriors had the same, I think. Maybe they were the same for the Gurubashi. Maybe not. They have the same strings or colors in the back. Here is the other unit. They look very similar. Okay. You know that the Amani have different colors depending on if they are ranged or not. Okay, let's start the battle. About it, we could probably send some of our range units. Ah, they've started to fire. Good. Don't need to order them. It's better to let them not be AI controlled, then they will use their arrows. The infantry will move and attack them. I mean, otherwise they risk attacking them in melee, which we didn't want. We have these alchemists, they shouldn't be used in melee, neither. They are good in melee, but should still be used from afar if we have the choice. A lot of these bottles they carry. Deadly alchemist fire. So this time they are used from afar. The ogres have been modified. Alchemists, so they are purple. They're shooting a giant. No, it's the bomber that fired that. Would like to see what these guys are firing. What the alchemists are firing. Maybe the enemy wasn't near enough, close enough. So against the trolls, the trade coalition is doing quite well, despite the infantry disadvantage. I believe against Stormwind it will be more difficult, because they have a lot of cavalry, heavy cavalry. Thank you. job. Let's just fire from there. Fared well. They are pretty good, these guys, the old necrolites. Oh, now they fire. Ogres. Goblin alchemists. Explosive, so they are like the sappers, but the beam I think could be improved, because as we see, the bottoms are way larger here than they are for the sappers, but the beam they fire is still the same, I believe. I will check that. If it's the very same, we will change that, because in Heroic War there is like the Goron bomb platforms and Goron bomb throwers throw a similar projectile, but it's bigger. I'll probably try to port it and use that one. Then they will be much bigger. We'll see, but I don't know if they look bigger in the game when they are fired. We'll have to check it. Only if they look bigger will I do that. Because yeah, they should probably look about the same size as these bottles. Now they are out of ammo, so they draw their twin blades. They are also good in melee. Right, then we can... we've lost the infantry force already. The trolls are upon us. Okay, it's time to move back the general. Move back those ogres. No, they can fight. They defeated our infantry already. Not stopped. Chinese are coming first, good. General's bodyguard. We killed 66% and lost 15%. The trolls are losing. They crushed our infantry. Give us half our army. The second army is at full strength. I love playing this game when it doesn't lag. It's a nice feeling. Playing with huge armies arriving and reinforcing in a world where a nostalgic world like Warcraft or Hero, you know, Game of Thrones. Why are they not firing? Too far away. Ally, handle the rest of the battle. They are moving back, the trolls. Maybe they are retreating from the battle. They might be. Still have large forces. Gurubashi troll tribe. Seem to be retreating out of the battle or repositioning. Maybe they want to be on a hill so they can fight our army better, or they want to retreat, fight another day. Still have the Jaeger warriors here. Very few of their cavalry unit still around, this mounted spearmen. Might be retreating. Didn't want to face our second army. Let's fast forward then. Yeah, they are retreating. That sucked. Hunt them. They're retreating towards the city, probably. Look at those forces. Huge goblin numbers. Trade collision numbers, because not all of them are goblins. There are humans, trolls, ogres in their ranks. He's the general. They're moving back with these trolls, so not all of them will retreat. They left a few that will stand and fight, including probably their basic unique militia unit, the Gurubashi primitives, and a unit of Gurubashi warriors have been sacrificed, and remnants of the enchanted tick warriors. Viva unit hit. Just fire at them very well. General, he doesn't get reinforced in time. Send forth those troops. Bloodlust, which will decrease fatigue of the hero's own troops, these troops, by minus 2000 for a period of time. Broken, good. They still have one unit left. Where is the rest of their army? The Scorpion has a jungle troll blue skin for the rebels. Let's check that up. Look it up. If that's the case, we might add a Scorpion to the Gurubashi. Would be worth it. They do not have any heavy cavalry, so making them worse than the Farraki. Would add a Scorpion. They can still get Scorpions looking like the Farraki Scorpions from Farraki areas, but if they have a unique blue skin, then I think we could add it to the Farraki too. I mean, the Gurubashi, these trolls, they will also have the Scorpion. It will increase their skill in battle. They can share the Scorpion if they have a unique skin anyway. So we killed 94%, lost 16, end the battle. Clear victory, we killed 899 with our main army. Lost 488, 941 remaining. Restored some units after the battle. The enemy killed only, now our ally killed only 40, killed 0. The enemy killed 489. Lost 1985, so they were really bad. Battle statistics: Eastern Stranglethorne Vale, 618 after the dark portal opened. Our best unit was the higher troll ambushers. Killed 417 of the enemy and 392 of the enemy. So you see, they are really good from afar, but when they are wasted in melee, they are not very good. Necrolites killed 183. Heavy men 150. Alright. What about Goblin Alchemists? Maybe the grenadiers like alchemists and sappers etc. should have more ammunition, because they can hardly kill anyone. Because they ran out of ammo. This there now we'll see. Might improve the grenadier type units. Look up the ammunition if there is a bigger bomb for the alchemists we can use. And yeah, the scorpions might be available to the Gurubashi too in the next release. I will look up if they had a blue skin. If they do, we might add the scorpions to the Gurubashi as well. I believe the Telabim Rebels had that in the past, which are Djungle Troll Rebels. They decrease. Alright, we can attack the settlement again. This army can only move over there. So we need to attack infantry. We don't need them if they are one. Let's ban.
Say the word. Orders. What do you need? Orders.
All right.
Yes, my liege. What do you need?
Infantry here.
What do you need? Yes, my liege.
Half an army of infantry.
What do you need? Yes, my liege. What do you need? Say the word.
Yes, archers.
Yes, my liege. What do you need? Orders? Yes, my liege. What do you need?
general leader of can lay siege. The general sends the outcast here, reinforced by the remnants of the army we just fought. Right, this army can't move anymore this time.
Orders. Yes, my lead.
We could probably orders. Move some of their troops.
Say the word.
The rest of that army couldn't move. General. And we are out of money, so we can move this general to the troops. Need to defend against the Sandlarity. Against others here. Let's end turn. Report. Alright. Construction announcements. Construction report. Recruitment report. Dramatic information. The following factions are now at war with each other. Dark Iron Wolves and the Wolves of Casmauden. Kingdom of Kveldlas, which is the High Elves. Against the Mani Troll Tribe. The Forest Trolls.
You need.
Of course, we'll add the general here. We are out of money. Bad. So it needs attack somewhere.
Yes, my liege.
Leave one unit somewhere.
What do you need?
Tail gunner unit, maybe. Okay, you can leave the these two. Attack with the rest. Fight the Farraki Trolls. You have Exento, Blood Tusk, family member. Bullguard of Farraki Champions, Bullguard. He's not their leader. He has a unique new unit, Farraki Shadow Glades. A rogue unit. They have elite unit, the Sanctuary Zealots. The Blood Drinkers, they have zombies too. They're similar to the Scourge and Forsaken Zombies, just with a different model. A different name.
Yes, my liege.
Probably move these guys. And these guys can be moved. Heck.
What do you need?
Alright, we have bombards here. It's never a good idea to have bombards. Same unit. We should have moved out the infantry. The general back to Abras. These troops there. Fight this battle. The general might be killed, I don't want to. Try this then. It's better, but the general might still be killed. End the turn instead. We are attacked by the Farraki Troll tribe. They have the scorpions too. Yeah, I'm pretty sure that the rebels had a blue scorpion. They should really add this heavy cavalry unit to the Gurubashi Trolls as well. On a strength ratio 3-4 in their favor. We might lose, but we will fight the battle. We only had one infantry unit, so we will not let them be AI control. We will suicide the infantry unit. And then we will order the others to just fire at will. And if the enemy reaches the troops, then we will put them in AI control. Start deployment. Kamek on. Still group them in different groups based on unit type. Pirates and other gunners will be one group. The normal gunners. Loose formation. Archers in another group. Fire ammo on. Loose formation. Fire at will. And that's true for this unit.
I'm alone.
Then we have the elite gunners. Will be loose formation fire at will. Then we have the infantry. Start the battle. They have zombies. They are very slow. They'll take forever until they reach the army. The next release will probably replace their animation with normal infantry animation. So they will be fast. And they will probably still be hard to shoot down. I believe enemy army troops. Have a cavalry unit. Mounted Sand Fury Warriors. Here version of the Mounted Warriors. Firing a laser beam. Let's attack them. Bandits. They have infantry advantage. Both the numbers and quality. Oh, they even have these scorpions. They have red scorpions and yellow scorpions. I believe the other rebel ones were blue and white, but I could be wrong. They would be perfect for the Gurubashi. Like a good heavy cavalry unit. Already defeated our bandits. They're not good against scorpions. The weakness of this force was that it was only ranged units. Pirates are still decent in melee. Pirate musketeers. There is our elite unit. They can't be allowed to be in melee. The cavalry over here. They're fighting on a mountain. Hammer twisted. Alright. So we killed 18% and lost 28%. We might lose this battle. Because we only had ranged units. They are good, but they are not good in melee. Needed to lose troops. We were out of money. This defeat will help us with the bankruptcy. So I kinda sacrifice them. Gamble the troops we had here. Seem to have lost. These are the Shadowblade rogues. Shadow blades. Alright. Here we got slaughtered. Killed 26% and lost 48%. It will help the economy. Main reason why I attacked. Move them out. Seems we didn't win without the infantry. We hardly have any cavalry anyway. Helmets compared to the others. They're very similar. With different stats too. Gurubashi will be aided by having the scorpions. We already have the skin to use to the rebels. This will be fine. Bash a bit against Stormwind and others, and then the scorpions too. I also managed to overwrite the wild raptors when I had the troll regional recruitment for the cities. We'll have to re-add the wild raptors to the Farraki. I'm having a treat now. There's zombies over here. There's zombies, they move like zombies, but yeah, we will change animation to be like a normal unit. Just still keep their numbers. These guys are still firing. Killed 40%, lost 65%. They're firing at these trolls, troll archers of the Farraki troll tribe. Oh, we still have the artificers too. They're killing them en masse. They're much more effective than the others. 60 goblin artificers are remaining. hill gunners. These are the artificers. Best gunners the faction. Only the dwarves of Casmodan without their dwarves are similar gunners. The humans do not have any elite gunners. I believe Stormwind has the marines and the S15 or so, SI5, but Stormwind intelligence 5 or so gunners, but they are not as good as these guys. They are elite, but they are still much worse than these. The Dark Iron Wolves have a really good one, and the Casmodan Wolves too. Sanctuary blood drinkers. 1% and lost it to 2%. They are coming with more troops, including their bodyguard unit here. Farraki champions bodyguard. Many of them. Here's their general, the cape. Still put up a decent fight. They should have had some infantry other than the one bandit unit. Then we could have won. Disaster because we only had ranged units essentially. They are very effective if we have infantry in between them and other infantry. These guys are still really good. We lost 83%, they lost 65%. But these units, are they zombies or something? This unit is a zombie unit. Another one. Yeah, the bandits had no chance against their elite infantry. Against the scorpions especially, which is heavy cavalry. Alright, so you will lose this battle probably. We still killed 68% and lost 84%. We'll kill some more before we lose probably. If it was only the zombies we would be in. But those champions bodyguard are really good. Broke pirate unit there. Putting another one in Lee. The last campaign I played as the Goblins, they had medieval vanilla voices in battle, so it feels much better with some of their units having human voices and the others having no voices. I like that much better. Makes them feel more custom. They have no narrator, unfortunately. Them. That beam could probably be used for Star Wars if you make a medieval 2 Star Wars mod. You port that beam, essentially a laser beam. Look at it. One would just need to replace the orange color with red and green, essentially. Lost 88%, we might be able to win. It will take a while. Never good to only have ranged units in an army. Look at that, how effective they are. Killing. Unlike Star Wars, ruin tiles that always miss. These guys always hit, it seems. Killed almost their entire bodyguard. They're attacking the wrong unit. They had attacked the laser guys. would have been a bigger problem. They might be protected by the hill, but I don't believe so. We'll see. We are out of ammo, fuck. And I think we'll retreat with them. To be honest. It's an elite unit, we don't want to base them. So that's their melee weapon. Giant mace or whatever, club. We retreat, because we're out of ammo. Pirates will fight to the death. Still have the trolls. Maybe they can still fire. I should do it. Troll ambushers, the trade collision, led by the goblins. Giant weapon too. Kill 75% of the enemy, and close to 89%. They still have the zombies as well, far away, or a bit away. They are retreating with their general's bodyguard, Farraki champions. That's the only one left. 75 here. believe they had zombies too. Let's fast forward. Takes forever. They run around. There's the other force. Okay. Send them here against those guys instead. The zombies have pretty good hit points they can take before dying, so they might not die due to ranged fire from the archers. Some of them will die, but I mean, most of them won't. We can take 3 hits, I believe, from arrow fire before dying. I sent 4 troll ambushers and 25 pirate musketeers. We might still lose this battle. Zombies here. One unit, and they have another unit somewhere else. Zombies. Down here. Yeah, the zombies will be normal units in terms of running around and attacking. They won't be as slow. In the next release, we won't keep the zombie animation. It looked cool, but it takes forever for them to reach the battlefield. And it wasn't possible to speed it up either. We are killing some of them. Ammo. Okay, then we will send in the trolls melee against the zombies. General Fall. Kill their general. And the last bodyguard unit there. That's the general. They're celebrating his death. Trolls are fighting in melee. Fire, the zombies, their guns. These are the Farraki zombies. They look like normal trolls. Just a little bit less colorful. Maybe they are more pale. Zombies might win against ambushers. Speed forward this. So we have 25 pirate musketeers, 55 ambushers, and 96 zombies. They are not firing. place them here instead. Yeah, zombies are really bad. They are losing already. They will lose against the trolls. Another zombie unit. 28 zombies. Attack it instead. Kill 86%, I kill 96%. Third troop. They won here, with 31 remaining. 175 over there, let's attack them now. Might not win that. Can probably, they took out those guys good. Let's fire at the numbers over there. Firing. Don't need those formation anymore.
Orders.
Enemies killed, 97% allies killed. I think we can win this battle after all. But we lost unnecessarily many. We restore some troops after the battle. So we'll disband any troops that we don't need to improve the economy. Zombies. 7 zombies. Zombies will win that fight. Believe.
Them all.
This tactic won't hurt when they have normal animations, they won't be slow enough. Then they will just run towards gunners. Meaning, we can't just kill them from afar like this. So, now we have more numbers than they do. Kill 99%, we will lose 98%. Zombies fight to the death, they never pray. But they can withdraw from the battle. Probably change that. We shouldn't be allowed to draw zombies. We should always fight to death. They're too slow to withdraw. Maybe if they can run with normal animations, they should be allowed to withdraw, but I don't think so. The zombies have no minds of their own. So. Four remaining. Musketeers have a lot of shots. We won the battle. Awesome. Average victory. Enemies killed 1500. And we lost 1179 men. We have 317 remaining. We had 1496 at the beginning. The enemy army had 1508 men, so the numbers were even. Under X and Toe, Blood Tusk of the Farraki Troll tribe, they lost 1503, if I remember, killed 1273, and I don't know if this is taken prisoner 83 or if it's that they killed their own, I don't know. Anyway, battle statistics, Western Tannery is 618 after Dark Portal. So we won the battle. Then we will restore some units after the battle. There will probably be too few to be worth having. We will disband them if that's the case. We will move back the army towards I believe Gadgetzan. We are too weak to advance any further. Attack again. Captain Untoe of the Farraki Troll Tribe, 356 trolls. an elite Farraki champions unit, an ordinary century normal spearman unit, it's like a medium unit, and a mage Farraki hydromancers elite unit. It's like the water elementals, but it's hydromancers using them. Pretty cool. Save the game so we don't have to replay the other one. Army strength ratio 9, 10 in their favor. We will fight the battle on the battle. Stop deployment. Cam Hecon.
Prepare to die! Aye, my lord. Say the word.
Looks for magic with all the ranged units. Fire wheel on. We have 150 bandits. We restore the entire bandit unit. Perfect. They will be crushed by their elite infantry unit. Still charge. When they get closer. Our artificers will kill most of their medium infantry. Like summoners with water elementals. Cool. Maybe the human version should have the human mages with water elementals. Might try to merge the units. It would make sense. Back, perfect. These female trolls are all it's also a young person. They are not summoners. They use a different projectile. This the Farraki troll tribe is the only tribe with female trolls, but other trolls can hire Farraki female trolls if they take Farraki areas. There should be a money and Gurubashi skins for these guys. Maybe we should get those skins so we can have they can look like Gurubashi and a money female trolls when they are in their army. I don't know. Quite a few of our gunners. Nice. Okay, the water elementals are the same projectile. But yeah, it's kind of a waste of stuff. It's better to combine them with the mage. Looked cooler. In Warcraft, mages usually summon water elementals, so they are not independent. Thank you. 5 bandits remaining. Left, the 18 artificers. The Hydromancer unit took out most of them. Fleeing, because they're being hunted. Then these guys. Oh, they're fucking the Hydromancers in the lead. 10 remaining.
Kill it! No!
This version of Warcraft of the War is unreleased. Map, but the map is still being worked on in the Frozen Throne campaign. This is the Reign of Caves campaign. This one is outdated compared to the one Bantu has or Seriidan has. We'll get the more updated version later. I already have one version that is more updated, but it's not been updated with my gameplay changes and want to do that again if I'm gonna get an even later one soon after, so that's why I play the oldest one. Still cool. Also I liked the for the player that the trade collision only had one area at the start. It was nice, but for the AI it doesn't work well. So that's why this one is fun to play, but they don't work as well for the AI. Thank you. give up if I didn't leave. They had some mace club like weapon in there. Combat 17 left anyway. Hydromancers have taken out most of them. They killed 95% of the troops. So our army was slaughtered. They're broken now. War God is really powerful, especially when aided by ranged units. Eight highwaymen. Knife was Lee. Fighting these guys. Maybe they should just charge them then. The Farraki would be fun to play too. Broken. He lost the battle. Killed 260, killed 382. Artificers killed 161, the others did pretty badly. Bandits killed 41. Alright, so the Gurubashi are attacking too. We'll just retreat. Not to win that one, to resolve that one. We lost. Prisoners released, the Farraki Troll tribes, they released the troops. Okay. We have no troops here. And here. Move these into. Get sand. We have no problem with the economy anymore. We needed to sacrifice the troops. Right. Infantry army. Good. Infantry army here. Right. We will attack with this force. We won't do it right now. We need to check the buildings first. Too broke to get anything there. We want to recruit anything. We need the money. Okay, so it's about the fleet. Move it over here. They have Thermor. They have a city in this version. Thermor Golden Pikes. By Central Rosh. What got a Thermor Archmage Magi? Alright. Move it onwards into this force. Merge the units. General there, more troops coming here. Cavalry could move.
Yes, my liege. Say the word.
The infantry.
Yes, my liege. Say the word. Yes, my liege. Yes, my liege.
All right. Now we can attack. Start this battle as we've already fought these trolls before. Captain Kufa here, 151 trolls. Including troll warriors, troll axe throwers, troll spears, and the Gurubashi unique tribal warrior militia. Then we have the general, Sansel the outcast, with the bodyguard of disciples of Hakkar, and his army, more of the tribal warriors. Gurubashi primitives, they are the militia, and the tribal warriors are actually, I think they are medium troops, unique for the Gurubashi. These guys are medium troops, shared with the Bantu Trolls. Farraki have similar trolls, just with slightly different stats. The Bantu Trolls are exactly the same. We have the Gurubashi headhunters, they have a cavalry unit, and the troll warriors. Alright, I will end here for now. We will continue probably this video, but I need to do some stuff. See you soon.